Hey guys, today I am going to show you the concept of hand pollination in custard apple, sharifa or cherry moya tree. We have a couple of custard apple plants. Both are having flowers in different stages. There is this concept of hand pollination which is utilized to increase the yield of custard apple fruit. This has been utilized in the past couple of years and it has given a mixed result. I'll take this clump for demonstrating the different parts of the plant. So of course we have got these leaves and we have a few buds, flowers, a young custard apple which is forming. There is a withering flower which has not got fertilized. So this is the flower which is forming and will open by tomorrow. Once the custard apple flower opens, it remains a female for a day. After a day, it will shed its female characteristics and turn into a male. The female flower is quite a closed flower. The petals are pointing downwards, falling almost parallel to each other. And later on, when it turns into a male, it becomes like a tripod. The petals will open up like this. We can now see the fertilized flowers which are set to turn into custard apple. So this is a custard apple which is forming. The withered petals are still holding on to it, but they will be ultimately shed. Just show you. So this is how they are shed off. And this is the one which has not got fertilized. After completing its cycle, it is going to wither off and fall. Now you have seen all the stages of the flowers, the buds, both avatars of the flowers, that is the female and the male, the fertilized flowers which are going to turn into custard apple fruit, and spent flowers which could not make it and are going to fall off. This is a male flower because one can see the inner parts of the flower. From the side, you can see that the petals have spread out. And even from here, we can see the inner parts. You can make out the reproductive parts of the flower are well visible from down below. I have tilted the flower slightly in order to show this to you. This is a female flower. And even though the petals are starting to diverge, if I turn it towards the camera, you can see that the inner parts are barely visible. Another female flower. So you cannot make out the reproductive parts of the flower from here. It is quite closed arrangement. You can see that a little bee has just visited. In the natural world, the nature takes care of the pollination and care of the custard apple flowers. So beetles and bees which visit these flowers transfer the pollen from the male to the female flowers, fertilize them, and these get converted. But in the real world, you would like to have as much of yield of the custard apples as is possible. In order to get the bumper harvest, one has to resort to the technique called hand pollination. And this video is all about that only. For demonstration purpose, I'll be choosing this male flower and this female flower. I'm using a fine sable-haired brush. So this will serve the purpose of a pollinating insect. I'm going to gently introduce this brush head inside this male flower and give it a gentle twirl. Probably you can make out a speck of pollen deposited almost at the tip. Next, I'll be taking this pollen-bearing brush to the female flower and I'll again gently take it inside and give it a slight twirl so that the pollen gets deposited on the stigma. One has to be very careful so as not to be overzealous, else there is a risk of damaging the flower parts. Here's another male flower. So this goes inside gently. Normally I would have stabilized the flower with my other hand, but as I'm holding the camera, that option is not available with me. Once again, I'll proceed towards the female flower. I have been getting mixed results. Most of these have been hand pollinated and have got fertilized and now turning into custard apple fruit. But this way of moving from one flower to the other flower is a tedious and cumbersome process. So instead, what I do is I collect the pollen in a container. I'll be visiting all the male flowers of this plant and gathering the pollen inside this container. And once I'm through with the male flowers, I then make another round in which I pick up the pollen from this container and pollinate each female flower. So this is a better way because sometimes the number of males are more, sometimes females are more in number. So this way we get a balance of the hand pollination process. Showing that process is not possible because I am holding the camera with one hand and I have to hold the brush with the other hand. But this is how I position the container underneath the male flower, and with a brush I will try to pick up the pollen. Invariably they fall down also, so they are gathered in the container. I visit from one male flower to the other, and likewise once I am through with the male flowers, say this is a female flower, so again I'll be holding this container underneath it, and as I deposit the pollen into the female flower, some pollen which falls down does not get wasted. It is gathered in the container only. This way, whichever unused pollen is there can hold for a day or so. I can carry it over to the next day, and the next day I will be using it to fertilize the female flowers. So I have gathered some pollen. There was sparse pollen today because of fewer male flowers, and also they were having less of pollen. Whatever I could gather, I have taken in this container, and now I'll be visiting the female flowers and picking up these grains and transferring them to the female in the hope that they get fertilized. All around there is this mild, sweet and intoxicating fragrance which has to be experienced. Not everything can be captured on the camera, and this fragrance is one of those things. This ladybird will be playing an important part in the health and well-being of the plant because it devolves the aphids which infest the plant and keeps the population of these pests under check. So this is all that I wanted to show you about the hand pollination of the custard apple, Sharifa, Cherimoya, sugar apple. This can give you a good yield of custard apple fruit. What I have felt is that it gives easily 5 to 10 times the yield which was coming our way when the pollination had been left to the natural ways. Bye for now. Take care. Have a good day. Ta-ta.